Hi friends, welcome back. This week's recipe is going to be a Diwali special from the Sindhi cuisine. I'm going to make satta bhajum, which means seven vegetables. This sabji is made in almost all the Sindhi homes on Diwali day. We also call it chachar bachar, which means something like pot puri. So all these vegetables are cooked together in the caramelized onion gravy, dagawari bhaji. We can put any vegetables we like, but two of the vegetables are supposed to be important on this day. We are supposed to eat them definitely on Diwali day, which are, one is chibra, which is called kachri in Hindi. It's a wild cucumber family vegetable. It's usually grown in desert region, not easily available everywhere. So what we do is we get from our Sindhi grocery store the dried version of it, chibra ji kachri, and we put that in the bhaji while cooking. What I do is, these days I couldn't find that, so I'm making use of this IV gourd, which is also similar. It's like a mini chibra. So I'm adding this one because I couldn't find that. And the second one is radish. It is said that radish also is must on Diwali day. I don't know the reason why, but we have seen our elders doing that, so we are following the ritual. In fact, on Diwali day, during the puja, we keep radish leaves like this in the chhaj. This is called chhaj. We keep it in the prayer room at night next to the this hatni. This is called hatni. We light a diya inside, and this chhaj is kept along with the prasad of chikki, gurdani, which we make specially for Diwali. All these are kept in the puja room next to the hatni. So this is something, the rituals we have seen our elders doing, so we follow them. Now coming back to the sabji, let us go and prepare the satta bhajum, or the seven vegetables, chachar bachar. To make satta bhaji, I have taken 4 small potatoes, 1 carrot, 1 capsicum or bell pepper, 2 small brinjals or eggplants, 7 or 8 IV gourds or tendli, cauliflower, few florets, and a piece of radish. For the spices, we'll require salt to taste, 1/2 teaspoon red chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon cumin powder, 1 teaspoon coriander powder, and 1 teaspoon garam masala. We'll also require coriander leaves for garnishing, 3 to 4 tablespoons of oil. Now here I have cut all the vegetables into large pieces. Immerse them in water until you cook. Here I have about 1.5 cups of caramelized onion gravy paste. Fry the onions till brown, cook them with tomato, ginger, garlic, green chili, blend them to the paste. Check out the link I have shared in the description box. I had posted this video some time back, so you can check it out, how to make dag. Now place a pan and pour the oil. Heat it very lightly on low flame. Now first we are going to add all the spice powders except garam masala powder. And remember, the oil should not be very hot when you add, otherwise the spices will become black. This is the tip: when you put the spices and fry in the oil before adding dag, they give out extra flavor. The curry becomes very tasty when you fry the spices this way in the oil. But make sure the flame is low and the oil is not too hot. Now, when it starts to bubble, you can add the paste, onion paste. Now saute this paste for a couple of minutes. Until you see the color changes. Now add salt. Now you can dip in the vegetables.
Now stir fry the vegetables on medium flame. Keep stirring for 2 or 3 minutes until you see the gravy paste has coated on all the vegetables. Keep adjusting the flame. You can add beer also in this curry. They taste really good, but I couldn't find them. Add 1.5 cups of water, or according to the quantity of the curry you are making. You check it out. Stir everything together, and when the gravy starts to bubble, you can cover the lid. Allow it to simmer. This takes about 10 to 12 minutes. Keep stirring in between very carefully. Now you can check the salt, because at this stage you can add if it is required. I think I need to add little more salt. Mix it very gently. Now the Diwali bhaji, satta bhajiyon, it's getting nearly done. Final stage, you can add the garam masala powder. Reduce the flame and simmer it again for a couple of minutes. Now you can open and check with the edge of the knife if the vegetables are done. Yeah, they are cooked very well, and the gravy also has thickened. Garnish with coriander leaves. You can see that the gravy is thick now, but before you serve, when you keep the curry, the gravy thickens little more. So keep it accordingly. Here Diwali bhaji chachar bachar is ready to be served. We usually serve it with rotis, but it can be paired with pulao also. Friends, if you are new to the channel, do subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notifications. You may check out these videos as well in case you have missed them. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.